Hey Titans, thanks for checking this out. I want to show you some tricks about how to make a gear or a cog. And I have two different ways that I can do it. One that I've practiced and one that I will just try. If you look right here, I have a couple of concentric circles and I have one of the teeth for this gear that I want to use. So the first thing that I'll do is take these three objects and I want to align these by using horizontal align. So they're all lined up perfectly like this. On your screen, you might see the align tools up here. When you have anything selected with the regular selection tool, the black arrow. And here's what I want to start doing. Choose the object that I want to rotate around my circle. It's the tooth. And we're actually going to rotate from an offset point. So here's how to make that work. So go find my rotate tool. Sometimes it's underneath the reflect tool. And I need to choose the center point by which to rotate this tooth. I want it to be the center of these two concentric circles. So I can find that with smart guides. And I need to hit option and click. And you can see right now that it's keeping this as the center point to rotate this. And let's see, we have 12 teeth around here. Anybody know what 360 divided by 12 is?
It's 30.
Well, you don't even have to know because you can type the math directly into this. So I can type 360 divided by 12.
That's interesting.
And it'll be 30. Let's preview it. So this is where my second tooth would be if I just hit OK. Instead of hitting OK, though, I want to hit copy. And what I've done is made that rotate along this center point and made a copy at the same time. Now, I need 10 more of those, and there are a couple of ways to do that. I can go to transform and transform again. Because I have all of these rotation tools inside object and transform, but it tells me also that Command D will do the same trick. So let's try it. Command D until I get all the way around. So this might be pretty good for my first gear, except I'll have to use my Pathfinder to do a few things with it. Let's select everything except for, I'm going to hit shift and get rid of that one. You are not selected. And I'll hit unite. Then I want to get rid of this green one. So I'll subtract from the front. Hey, that works pretty well. If you need to rotate this one further, you can use your regular rotate tool to make it line up with your art. Or you can just animate it. Now we're going to try another trick to make this one. I'm making three concentric circles. And I think I'll change the colors of those and probably layer them up a little bit. And then I'll go use this tool in here inside my shapes. And I'll choose the star tool. The star is going to come from the center point. I'm going to hit the up and down keys until I get the right number of points. I can't count the one underneath. But I think it was something like that. Let's go down. How many? Was this a 7?
Yeah, that's 7.
Okay, we'll see if it works. So now it's all about using the Pathfinder a couple of times. I want to take all of what's outside of that one away. So I think I'm just going to divide. And get rid of these ones. And then I want to take this magenta shape and this cyan shape and put those together.
Cyan.
Then I can just take away that green shape. And there's a different way to make a cog or a gear. So I just want to show you a couple of things you can do with it if you're making this icon. Here's some other art that I did before, and I wanted to make a gap around here. I already made a video doing something really similar with a different object. So here's an offset path, and here is kind of a finished version of that project. The gears are a little bit different, but hopefully you can see how you might make that work. Thanks for watching.